स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द ज्योग्राफी क्लास फॉर क्लास 7. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद द न्यू लेसन, लेसन नंबर 7, यूरोप पॉलिटिकल एंड द फिजिकल फीचर्स. की कंसेप्ट्स ऑफ द लेसन आर इंट्रोडक्शन, लोकेशन, बाउंड्रीज, पॉलिटिकल डिवीजन, कंट्रीज विद कैपिटल्स, मेजर फिजिकल फीचर्स, लोकेटिंग द कंट्रीज ऑन द मैप ऑफ यूरोप. Learning outcomes of the lesson are: children will be able to locate Europe on the world map, identify the countries of Europe, locate the major physical features of the continent of Europe, know the different water bodies of Europe. Students, let us discuss now the terms to be discussed in the today's video. Continents, huge land masses of the earth. Ocean, large water bodies. Mountains, high hills with pointed peak. River, natural stream of water flowing from higher ground level to lower ground level. Sea, salty water body smaller than ocean. Watershed. Watershed is an area of land that separates water flowing to different rivers, basins or seas. Next, waterways. Waterways is any navigable body of water. Natural resources. Resources gifted by nature. Lake, deep depression on the earth filled with water. Populous, an area having large population. Peninsula, an area of land surrounded by water from three sides. Coastline, boundary line between sea and land. Island, an area of land surrounded by water from all sides. Gulf, an inlet water body surrounded by water from three sides. Let's start with the introduction of the topic. This is our planet Earth, the planet where we live. Continents are the huge land masses found on the Earth. The Earth has 7 such continents, from largest in size to the smallest. These are Asia, Africa, North America, South America, Antarctica, Europe and Australia. Today we will discuss about the Europe political division and the physical features. Let's read and understand more about Europe in detail. Europe is one of the world's 7 continents. Continents means huge land masses. It is the world's 2nd smallest continent in area after Australia. It is bordered by Arctic Ocean to the north, the Atlantic Ocean to the west, and the Mediterranean Sea in the south. Europe is separated from Asia by the watershed of the Ural and the Caucasus Mountains, the Ural River, Caspian Sea, and the Black Sea, and the waterways connecting the Black Sea and the Aegean Sea. It is believed that the name Europe was derived from Europa, the daughter of Phoenix. Some believe that it is evolved from the word Arab, which means sunset. In the past, Europe gave vast cultural and economic developments and achievements. Ancient Greeks and Romans contributed towards philosophy, literature, science, and fine arts. European people explored and discovered many new parts of the world in the early 15th century. No other continent had left such a remarkable impact on the world as Europe. Europe has been the birthplace of the Western culture. Europe has been responsible for the significant progress of the world in the past 300 years. Let's continue with the reading. Today, Europe has developed many folds, means many ways. It is the only continent which is both populous as well as prosperous. Populous means having large population, and prosperous means wealthy. The main reason behind this development is the belief in making the best use of natural resources and human resources. Natural resources means resources gifted by nature. Europe is a developed country in many ways. Europe is using its natural and human resources in a very good and efficient manner. It is the only continent which is both populous as well as prosperous. The countries in Europe show a large range of variation in terms of area, in which Russia tops as it is the largest country in the world. And the Vatican City is the smallest country in the world. So Russia is the largest country in the world. The Vatican City is the smallest one. Europe covers around 10,180,000 square kilometer, in which the highest point is Mount Elbrus, which is 5,642 meter above the mean sea level, and the lowest point is Russian shores of the Caspian Sea, which is 28 meter below the sea level. The Volga is the longest river of Europe, which has the length of 3,692 kilometer. The largest lake is Lake Ladoga. The literacy rate in Europe is nearly 95%. Literacy means ability to read, write, and understand a message of anyone language. Now we will explore more about Europe in this chapter. Let's start with the location point. Europe mostly lies in the northern temperate zone, as it lies beyond the topic of Cancer. So here you can mark the point zone with a small part of it extending beyond the Arctic Circle. Europe mainly lies in the northern and the eastern hemisphere, with some part of it reaching to the western hemisphere. Why so? Because students, the prime meridian 0 degree longitude passes through Greenwich near London in Europe. Some part of the Europe lies towards the west of the prime meridian. That's why it lies in the western hemisphere as well. The part of Europe which lies in the western hemisphere, consisting some countries like Portugal, Spain, Ireland, Iceland, the western United Kingdom and the western France. Now let us discuss about the latitude and longitude. Europe mostly lies in the northern hemisphere. Here the word hemisphere means half of the earth. The latitudinal extent of Europe is 35 degree north to 71 degree north. Students, here you can mark the point latitudinal extent of Europe. It implies that most of this continent lies in the northern temperate zone. Student, we have already discussed this point. You can mark the point zone. The small part of Europe lies beyond the Arctic Circle. The Arctic Circle passes specially from Sweden, Norway, Finland in Europe. So here students, one question comes that name the countries from where the Arctic Circle passes. So name of the countries are Sweden, Norway, Finland in Europe. The northern-southern extent of Europe is approximately about 6400 kilometer. So student, here is another point, north-south extent. You will write down these points on above of the lines that you will learn on the basis of Europe at the last. The longitudinal extent of Europe is from 25 degree west to 63 degree east. Students, here is another point. Longitudinal extent of Europe. The prime meridian 0 degree longitude passes through Greenwich near London in Europe. This is another point which is the important longitude. And student, write down the definition of prime meridian as well. 0 degree longitude that divides the earth into two equal halves. Students, the next point is the east-west extent. The east-west extent of Europe is about 4800 kilometer. This is another point, east-west extent. The size of Europe is 1,08,78,000 square kilometer. It covers nearly about 7% of the Earth's total surface area. The population in Europe is approximately 733 million. That is about 11% of the world's population. Europe is the third most populous continent after Asia and Africa. Let us continue with the next topic, border and coastline. Coastline means boundary line between land and sea. Europe is surrounded by water bodies on its three sides. That is, it is a peninsula. Peninsula means land surrounded by water on three sides. Actually, Europe is considered to be the peninsula of peninsulas because the seas have penetrated deep into the land. Except the eastern part, Europe is surrounded by water on its three sides. Most of the parts of Europe, except Russia, lie near the sea. Europe is situated between the Atlantic Ocean and the Ural Mountains in the west and the east, respectively, with the Arctic Ocean and the Mediterranean Sea in the north and the south part of Europe. The Ural Mountains, the Caucasus Mountains, the Caspian Sea, and the Ural River separate Asia from Europe. Europe is separated from Africa by the Strait of Gibraltar and the Mediterranean Sea. Europe is called Peninsula of Peninsula as it has many peninsulas in it. Except the eastern part, Europe is surrounded by water on all three sides. Most part of the Europe except Russia lie near the sea. Why Europe is peninsula? Because it has one side land, that is Ural Mountains in the east, and it has three sides water bodies, that is Atlantic Ocean in the west, Arctic Ocean in the north. In the south, it has Mediterranean Sea. So Europe is peninsula itself, and it has many peninsulas in it. The Ural Mountains, the Caucasus Mountains, and the Ural River separates the Europe from Asia. Europe is separated from Africa by the Strait of Gibraltar in the southwest. Here the word strait means a narrow piece of water body surrounded by land on three sides. Even the coastline of Europe is very long as well as broken at many places. Here the word coastline means boundary line between sea and land. Europe has excellent and highly developed harbors of the world. Harbor is a place where ships are kept and repaired. The continent possesses some of the major seas and gulfs, such as White Sea, the Gulf of Bothnia, the North Sea, the Gulf of Finland, and the Baltic Sea. In the north, the Bay of Biscay lying in the west, and the Adriatic Sea and the Aegean Sea in the south. And there are two large salted water lakes, the Black Sea and the Caspian Sea in the east. Let's continue with another topic, islands. Islands mean land surrounded by water from all sides. A large number of islands are found in the continent of Europe. The British Isles, Iceland, Sardinia, Sicily, and Crete are the most important ones. The English Channel separates the mainland from the British Isles. The British Isles are the group of islands in the north western coast of continental Europe, consisting of the islands of Great Britain, Ireland, and so on. Next is Sardinia. Sardinia is a large Italian island in the Mediterranean Sea. It has nearly 2000 km of coastline. The Sicily island is the largest Mediterranean island in just off the toe of Italy's boot. Crete is the Greece's largest island, is known for its varied physical features and sand beaches. The English Channel, also simply the Channel, is an arm of the Atlantic Ocean that separates southern England from northern France. It is the busiest shipping area of the world. Now, the students, we are going to recall the points which we have discussed in this video. On the basis of location of Europe, answer the following. Number 1, size. Europe is the 6th largest continent in the world. Number 2, hemisphere. It lies in the northern and eastern hemisphere. Number 3, latitudinal extent. Its latitudinal extent is 36 degree north to 72 degree north. Number 4, longitudinal extent. Its longitudinal extent is 25 degree west to 60 degree east. Number 5, important latitude. The important latitude passing from Europe is the Arctic Circle, 66.5 degree north. The surrounding water bodies of Europe are in the north, Arctic Ocean and the Norwegian Sea, in the southeast, Black Sea, the Caspian Sea, and in the south, the Mediterranean Sea. Next point is separated from Asia. Europe is separated by Asia by the Ural Mountains, the Ural River, the Caucasus Mountain, and the Caspian Sea. separated from Africa. It is separated from Africa by the Strait of Gibraltar and the Mediterranean Sea. Islands. The important islands are Sardinia, Sicily, Crete, Iceland and Ireland. Next, important longitude. The Prime Meridian passes through Greenwich near London in Europe. Its north-south extent is 6400 km and its east-west extent is 4800 km. Europe has an area of 1,878,000 square kilometer and it lies completely in the north temperate zone. So students, I have discussed all the points that you are going to learn and write in your copies, and you will follow the same pattern as I have shown. So students, this is the end of the today's topic. I hope you understood the topic and you are able to solve some exercises by yourself. Don't forget to learn the terms and the points which are given on the basis of location of Europe. I will come with the next video of the same chapter. Thank you. Have a nice day.